मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू आर क्लास. वी आर डूइंग आर 10th चैप्टर, दैट इज प्रैक्टिकल ज्योमेट्री. एंड इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव कंप्लीटेड आर एक्सरसाइज 10.1 एंड आई हैव गिवन यू द नोट्स आल्सो फॉर एक्सरसाइज 10.1. नाउ स्टार्टिंग आर एक्सरसाइज 10.2. इन दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न हाउ टू कंस्ट्रक्ट ट्राइंगल विथ ऑल द गिवन थ्री साइड्स, दैट इज Side criteria means here all the three sides will be given. We are going to use all the three sides to construct a triangle. So the first one, see the first one they have given, construct triangle XYZ in which XY is equals to 4.5 centimeters, YZ equals to 5 centimeters and ZX is equals to 6 centimeters. Means they have given all the three sides and we have to use all the three sides to construct the triangle XYZ. Means let us draw the rough diagram first and then we are going to start our construction part. See, this should be a triangle. Let us take X here, Y here and Z here. They have given XY as 4.5 centimeters, YZ as 5 centimeters and ZX as 6 centimeters. I have taken X here, Y here, Z here. You can change it. You can take it X here, Y here and Z here. It is according to your wish how you are going to take it. So I am going to take the triangle as like this and my sides X, Y, Z here. You can see that Y, Z is the base of the triangle and X, Y is a side part and X, Z also at the other side of the triangle. So first, using your scale, measure 5 centimeters. YZ measure 5 centimeters and keep the marking using your scale and pencil and draw a line segment. I am using the word line segment because the length of the line it is fixed 5 centimeters. So using your scale and pencil, measure YZ as 5 centimeters and name it as YZ and write the length of that line segment as 5 centimeters. Next, using your rounder, now open your rounder. We can see that XY is 4.5 centimeters. So measure using your rounder and your scale, measure 4.5 centimeters, keep the metal point at Y and draw an arc. Once again I am repeating myself, XY we have to draw, we have drawn the base as YZ 5 centimeters, we have to draw XY. So open, take your rounder, your scale, open your rounder and measure 4.5 centimeters, keep the metal point at Y and mark the arc for 4.5 centimeters. Next, again measure 6 centimeters using your scale and your rounder. Using your scale and your rounder, again measure 6 centimeters, keep the metal point at Z and cut that arc. Means the two arcs should meet at a point. So when you join, using your scale, when you join these points, your X will be there, this will be 4.5 centimeters and this will be 6 centimeters. Now this is the figure, correct figure which we are going to get after constructing our triangle. This is the rough figure I have taken. So seeing that I have drawn the base as 5 centimeters using your scale. After that, measure using your rounder and scale, measure 4.5 centimeters. Keep the metal point at Y and mark an arc of 4.5 centimeters. Next, measure 6 centimeters using a rounder and scale, keep the metal point at Z and cut the arc and using your scale join the lines to Y and Z. So here X is here, so this is 4.5 centimeters, this is 6 centimeters and this is your 5 centimeters. This is the triangle which you have to construct for your first question. After that, let us write the steps of construction. What will be the steps of construction? steps of construction. Whatever we are going to do step wise, we are going to write it in our own words, same how we have constructed it. What we have done first, we have measured 5 centimeters and we have drawn a line segment of 5 centimeters. So draw a line segment YZ of 5 centimeters. Next, second, what we have done, we have measured 4.5 centimeters using a rounder and scale, and we have kept the metal point at Y and we have marked an arrow here. So here the second statement will be, with the center as Y, draw an arc of 4.5 centimeters. Next, third, what we have done, with the center as Z, we have measured 6 centimeters and we have drawn the arc. So with the center as Z, draw an arc of 6 centimeters. Next, fourth one, join the points to Y and Z at X, capital X, at X. Thus, X, Y, Z is the required triangle. These are the steps of construction. Whatever we are going to do to construct a triangle, we are going to write it in our steps according to the step-wise. These are the steps of construction. Let us go for our second one. Second one, here it is given as equilateral triangle. We have to construct an equilateral triangle. We know that equilateral triangle, all the three sides are equal. For an equilateral triangle, all the three sides are equal. Let us draw a rough figure here. They have asked you to construct an equilateral triangle of side 5.5 centimeters. They have given one side. Let us name it as A, B and C. And they have given one side as 5.5 centimeters. And we know that an equilateral triangle, all the three sides are given. So here also 5.5 centimeters. Here also 5.5 centimeters. So we have to construct this figure. So first step for constructing a figure, draw a line segment BC of 5.5 centimeters using our ruler and pencil. Next, with the help of a rounder, measure 5.5 centimeters, keep the metal point at B and draw an arc. Next, with that same measurement, because it is an equilateral triangle, all the three sides will be equal. Keep the metal point at C and cut this arc. So join the points to B and C. So this is A. So here 5.5 centimeters and here 5.5 centimeters. So this is an equilateral triangle that we have to construct. My figure is not accurate because I'm drawing it with a free hand. When you're going to draw using your ruler and scale, ruler and your rounder, your figure will be accurate. So this is the second question. Construct an equilateral triangle of 5.5 centimeters. Same wise as we have done in the first question, steps of construction. First one, draw a line segment BC of 5.5 centimeters. Next, the second one, with B as the center, draw an arc of 5.5 centimeters. Next, third again, with the C as the center, draw an arc of 5.5 centimeters. Next, fourth one, join the point 2, B and C. Therefore, otherwise, thus, ABC is the required equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle. Because all the three sides are equal. These are the steps of construction. Simple. Keep your language simple. Whatever we are doing to construct the triangle, just write it like that. Keeping your language simple, though, so you are going to get the steps of construction. This is your second question. Now let us do the third question. Third question is, draw a triangle PQR. PQ is given as 4 cm, QR is given as 3.5 cm and PR is given as 4 cm. What type of triangle is this? They have given all the three sides of the triangle and they are asking you to construct the three sides, construct the triangle, and they are asking which type of triangle it is. What is the name of the triangle which you have constructed? So, let us start our rough figure. PQR. PQ is given as 4 cm, QR is given as 3.5 cm and here it is given as 4 cm. You can see that two sides of the triangle are equal, this side and this side. Which type of triangle is having two sides equal? It is an isosceles triangle. So the triangle which we are going to construct is an isosceles triangle because two sides are equal. So let us start the construction. The main figure. Draw a line segment QR of 3.5 cm. Next, using a rounder, measure 4 cm. Keep the metal point at Q. Mark an arrow. And with that same measurement, 4 cm, because this is an isosceles triangle, two sides are equal. Keep the metal point at R and draw an arc. Now join your points here. Here it is 4 cm. Here it is P. Here it is P. Here it is also 4 cm. These two sides are equal. So this is your figure that is to be formed. And in the last, after writing the steps of construction, the last we are going to write, thus the triangle formed is an isosceles triangle as it has two sides equal. Because it is having two sides equal, and so it is an isosceles triangle. After writing the steps of construction, in the last you can write this statement should to show that, because they have asked which type of triangle is formed by after constructing the triangle. So we have to write this statement that the triangle that is formed is an isosceles triangle because it is having two sides equal. So this is your third question. So let us go for our last question of this exercise. Steps of construction, you can write it on your own. Otherwise, I am going to give it to you in the PDF. So, you can copy it also. Next, fourth question. Construct a triangle ABC such that AB is equals to 2.5 cm, BC is equals to 6 cm and AC is equals to 6.5 cm. And they are asking you to measure the angle of B. They have given three sides and in this question, they are asking you to measure the angle of B. Means what is the measurement of B? So here a figure is like this. ABC. Whatever it is. AB. See here, AB is given as 2.5 cm, BC is given as 6 cm and AC is given as 6.5 centimeters. So just I have drawn the figure as rough only. After that, when we are going to construct, we are going to get the correct accurate figure. So let us draw line segment BC as 6 centimeters. After that, measuring 2.5 centimeters, keeping the metal point at B, draw an arc. Next, keeping measure 6.5 centimeters, keeping the metal point at C, cut the arc. When you the actual figure it is going to come, it will be an right angle triangle. Here it will be two arcs here, A, B, C. Means 6 centimeters, 6.5 centimeters and 2.5 centimeters. This is the actual figure which we are going to get. Means this is not the figure. This is the actual figure which we are going to get when after constructing the triangle by the given size. And when you see that they ask you to measure the angle B, so this is a 90 degrees. So in the last, angle B is equals to 90 degrees. Thus triangle ABC is a right angle triangle. We are going to, after writing the steps of construction, in the last we are going to write, because they have asked what is the angle of B. So angle B is 90 degrees, and we are going to mention, we are going to name the triangle because it is a 90 degrees and right angle triangle. So we are going to name the triangle as a triangle ABC as a right angle triangle. So this is your fourth question. In this exercise we have done the construct the triangle with the given three sides. They have given all the three sides and we have constructed the triangle. In the next exercise, two sides are given and one angle will be given. Means we are going to use the side angle side criteria in our next exercise. So this is the exercise 10.2. Let us continue in the next class.